La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah.
Once I saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam walking through the gullies and walking through the streets, telling the people, "Ayyuha nas, O people, qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu." Please say la ilaha illallah, and you will be successful. He says, and when he uttered that and he was walking, I saw some people abusing him. I saw some people cursing him. I saw others spitting on him, and I saw others throwing dirt on him, and he continued to move in this. And I saw a young girl running behind him with a bucket of water, and she was washing his blessed feet. Haris bin Haris said, I asked, who is this young girl? The people said, this is the Prophet's daughter Zainab radiallahu ta'ala. People divided themselves into different categories. Those who were throwing dust, they threw dust. Those who were throwing dirt, they threw dirt. Those of them who spat on his face, they did that. Those who abused him, they continue to do that. When you pass by some houses, you get this, he got this. When he passed by others, he thought this will come to an end, a new thing will begin. He will turn the corner thinking, well, now it's ended, he will get a new thing. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, subhanallah, bowed his head in humility, and he just continued saying, oh people, please accept this kalima. And he did not even turn to their direction. And the people did what they did. Similarly, Tariq bin Abdullah Al-Muharibi, he has narrated in the Musannaf of Ibn Abi Shayba. He says, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the marketplaces of Zulmajaz. Zulmajaz is the name of a marketplace where people go to sell their things and buy things also. We have marketplaces, a name called Zulmajaz. He says, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam going through from house to house. Every group of people he met, every person he met, he said, please recite this kalima and believe in this kalima, and Allah will help you, and Allah will make you successful in this life and the life hereafter. He said, I saw a man walking behind him, foot to foot, inch to inch, with stones in his hand. And anytime the Prophet spoke to someone, he will pelt him with the stone. And he will pelt him with the stone. And the man, when the Prophet told the people, oh people, say la ilaha illallah, the man will say, ya ayyuha nas, oh people, la tuti'uhu, do not accept this man. Do not listen to what he's saying. Fa innahu kathabun, he's a liar. And the Prophet will continue. He said, I saw the man. That man had stoned him so much that the entire body of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was smeared with blood. His daughter Zainab and other daughter Fatima will rush with water. The Prophet will be sitting at the side. They will be washing his body. They will be weeping. They will be crying and will say, Father, what is happening to you? Oh, Father, when will it end? When will it end? And he will sit to them, my daughters. He says, inshallah, one day, the message of your father will reach every home in this town. One day the message of your father will reach every home in this world. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went through such suffering that Anas radiallahu ta'ala said. Anas radiallahu ta'ala said, the hadith recorded in Musnad Ahmad and Abu Yahya. Anas radiallahu ta'ala says, once the Quraysh and the unbelievers had given such a beating to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he became unconscious. Can you imagine the kind of beating that it will take a man who has the strength of 40 human beings to fall unconscious? They struck him from every side. Who did not use the hands, use the feet? Who did not use the shoes, use sticks? Who did not use stick, use boulders and stones? And they got him unconscious. He fell on the ground. As soon as Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala and his close companion heard that, he rushed to the scene. And he says, أَتَقْتُلُونَ رَجُلًا يَقُولُ رَبِّيَ اللَّهِ. He says, what is wrong and matter? What is the matter with you people? Are you killing a man who says, my God is Allah, the one creator? And they started on him also. And they started to beat him, and they fell on him from all sides. until he was beaten, and it says that his entire head was covered with blood. He also fell unconscious. He had to be moved to his home, and the Prophet was moved to the home. Urwa bin Zubair radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Urwa bin Zubair, who is from among the great Tabi scholars, once he said to the Sahabi Abdullah bin Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala, he says, tell me something about the sufferings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Tell me. He said, once I can remember, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was performing salat, the hadith recorded by Imam Bukhari, he was performing salat in the Hatim of the Kaaba. He says, suddenly Uqba bin Abi Mu'id came, and he took a piece of cloth and he tied it around the throat of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he started to pull it to the extent that it looked as if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was about to die. And he continued to pull it until Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala and so on, he came and he pushed him away. And it is about this incident Allah revealed in the Quran, أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يَنْهَى عَبَدًا إِذَا صَلَّى. Don't you see the one who stops his servant from performing salat when he's performing salat in the Kaaba to Allah? He nearly killed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abdullah bin Masud radiallahu ta'ala narrates, as recorded by Imam Bukhari alayhi rahmah, Abdullah bin Masud radiallahu ta'ala says, once I was by the Kaaba, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was performing salat in the precincts of the Kaaba, and in the Kaaba there were the chiefs of the Quraysh, of the unbelievers, Abu Jahl, and all the others like Uqba bin Abi Mu'id, Ubay bin Khalf, and all these people. And all of them were sitting and looking at him. And they say, "Unzur ila hadha al-mara'i," look at this one who is showing off. Na'uzu billah, this is what they are saying about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at this one showing off. And then Abu Jahl said, "Which one of you is so brave to go and bring the intestines of the dead camel of so and so and throw it on the back of the Prophet sallallahu on the back of Muhammad when he goes for sajda?" The worst of all of them, who was Uqba bin Abi Mu'id, he got up, he says, "I will do it." And he looked for a carcass, a dead camel lying at the side of the street, and the intestines came out. You know, they cut open the stomach and the place, it was dirty, it was impurities, it was given off the most heinous stench. He lifted it up and he came. Subhanallah. He waited for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to go in sajda. And when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went in sajda, he took the entire thing and he placed it on the back of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was so heavy the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could not move from sajda. And you know what happened? While that was on the back of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of them started to giggle and gaggle and laugh at that. And they were laughing to such an extent that they were actually falling on each other. يَمِيلُ بَعْضُهُمَ عَلَى بَعْضٍ, recorded by Imam Bukhari. They were actually falling on each other and pointing, "Look, look, look," you know, when people are laughing and they are pointing. Fatima radiallahu ta'ala found out, Abdullah bin Masud says, He says, "I wish I had the strength in my hand to do something. I couldn't. They overpowered me. Had I done anything, they would have inflicted upon me some persecution. So although I was there, I was looking at what they did, I had no power and strength in my hand to do anything. All I could have done was just to sit back and look at what they were doing to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." He says, and somebody told Fatima about it, and Fatima came running. Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha was only 4 years or 5 years at that time. And she came and she moved it away. And she rebuked some of them. "What are you people doing?" And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when it was moved, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got up. And he turned to them and he says, "Allahumma alayka bi Quraysh. Allahumma alayka bi Abi Jahlin. Allahumma alayka bi Uqba bin Abi Mu'id. Oh Allah, oh Allah, you take care of this Quraysh people. Oh Allah, you punish Abu Jahl. Oh Allah, you punish Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayt." And he, seven leaders were there and he named them one by one. And when, as soon as he started to utter that, they started to tremble. All the laughter went. They became extremely serious. And they were taken aback. Because they knew, as recorded by Imam Bukhari, du'as in the Kaaba were always accepted. Supplications in that holy house, which is the house of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the house of Abraham, they were always accepted. And Abdullah bin Masud said, the names that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam called out, I saw all of them dead in the battle of Badr. They were killed. As he made dua, Allah destroyed all of them.
على مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا به للصالحات وللمكارم والتقى.